Sure. So Florence in Ecstasy is about an American woman named Hannah who has fled to Florence, Italy from Boston in the aftermath of dealing with some struggles in her own life. And while she's in the city of Florence, she becomes drawn into the life of the city by joining a rowing club where she learns to scull on the Arno River. But at the same time, she becomes fascinated by women of the past, by the medieval and Renaissance mystical saints who were famous for their ecstatic visions and also for starving themselves for God. Oh boy, I think my strongest memories, I mean, one of the things that I love about Florence and one of the reasons that it's important in the book is that it is a city that is sort of dense with history. And I was really interested in this book in looking at the history of women in the city and the history that you don't always see, the sort of through lines of these women from the past who had very strong narratives. So when I was there, I was looking for those women and I also found them everywhere. Absolutely. So I love, you know, Florence, like any city, is a complex and layered place, and I really wanted to show that in the book. So for example, one of the places that becomes a central place in the book is the rowing club, where Hannah learns to scull. And the rowing club is a real place in Florence, and it's located on the Arno River, directly under the Uffizi Gallery. So it's under one of the sort of most touristed, most famous sites in the city, but it's this hidden sort of secret place that's entirely Florentine. So I wanted to show more of those spots in Florence where you can see the city from a different perspective. And in the case of the rowing club, kind of from the inside out as Hannah is rowing on the river and seeing the city from within.